All right, everybody, it is good to be with you. Pastor Kevin here, bringing you today's daily devotion. This is a simple one. We are just crossing Mother's Day, and in a few weeks it'll be Father's Day, and I think it's a good time to remember to love on our families. And I'll get there in a second. One of the commandments is to honor your mother and father, that it may go well with you in your days, type of thing. And then later, Paul would say, children, obey your parents in the Lord. And it can get kind of tricky. My mother is a wonderful person, and she actually, I honestly believe that her fervent prayer for me and my brother are some of the very reasons why God would actually be involved in our lives. Is he wants to be there, but I think that my mom was somehow critical to that, because there were days that we had kind of stepped away, kind of stepped outside the faith, or whatever you want, however you want to put it, whichever tribe you belong to. The point is that we weren't necessarily doing kingdom things for periods in our younger lives, and my mom prayed. She prayed fervently for us. For our souls, for us being involved in kingdom work, those type of things. And I am so grateful for that. I am, like, utterly grateful. Again, and I believe God is sovereign. God does things that I don't understand, and he's done these things, and he's mapped out things before they happen, far before I can even get involved in it. So I'm only speaking of how I cherish my mother and her desires for us. To be kingdom kids, to be men who would step into the faith and actually do what they can in it with their gifts, right? So she did that for us. Some of you may not have parents, one that know the Lord, or maybe one that another, they're not around, or maybe they are around and they're just downright mean, or they abused you. And for that, I want to say, I'm sorry. I am very sorry. But I will say that the Bible, even when Paul says, children, obey your parents in the Lord, I think what he's saying is that specifically is saying, hey, when your parents know Jesus and they are actually giving you instruction and that type of thing, that is definitely biblical, it's definitely following the life of our King, then you are obedient. There are times when our parents would ask us to do something that's outside of God's will, right? When our parents ask us to do things that would be directly wrong with no apparent outcome other than our own, like maybe your parents' outcome or an outcome for you that's good for you. Those are the things that we have to be really careful of. But the general rule remains, which is we are to honor our parents. So I'd ask you, do you speak high, like even if you don't get along with your parents, do you speak negative about them, or do you speak positive about them? Because I'd argue if all you have is negative to say, then maybe it's better just not to speak about it. Do you pray for your parents? Like if you don't get along with your parents and you've had a rough time, do you pray for them? Maybe you've already lost them. Maybe they're gone already. I guess my point is that there is this biblical idea that we are to honor those that brought us into the world, regardless of the life that they spent with us necessarily. Now, that's not to say that we put, we raise anyone up to a standard that's not true. You don't do that. There's no necessity to do that. The Bible talks about truth, that we are to live our lives in truth. But I guess I'm just trying to get to the point of, one, are you honoring your parents? Are you loving on them? I mean, some of you do. You had good parents, but are you honoring them back? Maybe they're getting older in a stage of life where they could use you. You have to remember, for some of us, man, they changed a bunch of diapers. And I think sometimes it's now it's our turn. So I would just ask you, first and foremost, I don't know your particular situation. I don't know what you've gone through with your parents. But I would say that maybe this is a moment where we submit these things to our God and say, God, help me. Help me to love my parents better. I had a very good upbringing. I loved my parents. My father passed away when I was young. My mom was a rock all the way through. And I love her just amazingly. But I still need to get on my knees and say, how can I love her better? How can I give more of myself for her? How can I put off something so that I can maybe spend a little bit of time with her? So Mom, if you're listening, I'm trying and I'm asking God to help me. Anyway, I pray that this word would go with you today. Honor your parents, love them. Do your best, because I don't know your situation. So forgive me if you have, if you are feeling anxious by this conversation. I'm also available to talk about it. So you can always reach out to me. Okay, let's pray. Father God, we thank you so much for this day. I want to say, I'm going to speak purely from my individual perspective. Thank you for my parents. I pray that you would help me honor their memory and their legacy as much as possible, that I would actually be there for my mom as much as possible, as she's, you know, getting older. I pray that you would help me teach that to my children, and that their children would learn the same thing, that honoring your family line is important. It's not the equivalent of the gospel. We understand that, Lord. But at the same time, it is one of those things that can point to the goodness of what family is intended to be, which I believe is your ultimate desire, is to see these kingdom families around that are loving the gospel, loving each other, and pointing others to you. We want to do that today, Father. So through your Spirit, help us to do that. We love you. We thank you. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay, we'll see you all guys next time.